Okay, I'd like to show you some of the machine learning projects from Stanford. Yeah, we can go through this. Every semester they will try to keep the projects, machine learning related projects in this website, Stanford website. If you want, you can go through this in your free time. This will be helpful for your projects, E4 projects, when you go to E4. Year-wise, there are projects. Yeah, I can note down this one, this website. Later, you can try to note down this. And these are the references for this particular course. Pattern recognition course. The major reference is this book. If you want, you can buy this book. I think this will cost you around 600 rupees, that's it. But it will be very much helpful for you. Mostly, I'll try to follow this textbook only. Pattern classification by Duda and Hart. You can try to buy this book, if possible, second edition. And this is the second reference, Pattern Recognition and Machine Learning by C.M. Bishop. And if you want to learn further, if you want to go beyond this, the trending topics will be covered in this course, in this textbook, Deep Learning by Ian Goodfellow. You see, up to date till 2016, this textbook. And if you want to go further into artificial intelligence, you can try to have this book also, Reinforcement Learning by Sutton and Bartow. And this is a good book for probability course. It's a good reference book, Probability by Sheldon Ross. And this is for Linear Algebra Foundations. Probability and linear algebra are the prerequisites for this course. Not only this course, you can understand any signal processing or communication related courses. These two are the foundations. Probability course and linear algebra by Gilbert Strang. At least try to have this book, Pattern Classification by Duda and Hart. Oh, can you just tell me the expression for Gaussian distribution, Gaussian PDF? X is a Gaussian random variable with mean mu and variance sigma squared. Then can you just tell me the PDF for this, probability density function for this Gaussian? It's just a one dimension, right?
1 by under root 2 pi sigma square.
Root 2 by sigma square.
X minus mu square by 2 sigma square.
See, for all x belongs to real numbers, right? Minus infinity to plus infinity. This is a Gaussian distribution. Let me consider this one is mean mu and standard deviation. Standard deviation is sigma. Sigma is called as standard deviation. Square root of sigma square, right? Square root of variance is standard deviation. How much that is trying to deviate from the mean value indirectly. What is this height? The x versus fx of x. What is this height?
Root 2 pi sigma square.
1 by root 2 pi sigma square, right? If we substitute mu into this, x equal to mu. You see, e power minus 0 is 1, right? 1 by root 2 pi sigma square. This side is 1 by root 2 pi sigma square. Okay, I'll ask a question. Can you just tell me, this is a uniform distribution, 0 to 1 interval. Then what should be the height of this? What is the height of this? Is this a uniform distribution?
1.
1, right? Total area should be 1. The probability density function, PDF. Then what is the probability that x equal to 0.2? What is this probability? In this?
1 itself.
Is it 1? See, probability 1 means always you should get the outcome as 0.2 only, right? Is it true? Highest probability is always 1, right? Total probability should be 1. You can think, do you think probability density function is same as probability or different? They are different, right? Probability density function is not same as your probability. If you say that this equals to 1, it means that x is always equal to 0.1. But that's not true, right? X can take any value from 0 to 1 in the real space. Then what is the probability value for this? Okay, let me give you the hint. 0 to 1, how many real numbers are there? Okay, I will try to clear it further. Suppose 0 to 0.5, uniform distribution, then what is this height?
One by 0.5.
This is 2, right? Then what is the probability that x equal to 0.2 in this case? Is it 2? Is it correct?
Sir. No, sir.
It's not correct, right? Because highest probability is 1 only, right? You can't go beyond that. Then what is the probability that x equal to 0.2 here? It is probably density function. This is not a mass function. If that is a discrete case, that's called as probability mass function, which you can consider like a probability itself. If that is a discrete case, this is a continuous, right? Continuous random variable. The density is not a mass. I'll give one more hint. There are uncountably infinite numbers, right? 0 to 1 interval. And all of them are equally probable. Are equally likely in this case. We have an infinite numbers which are equally probable, then what is the probability for each number? See, if you are having n numbers which are equally probable, then what is the probability for each number?
1/n.
1/n, right? You are having uncountably infinite numbers. N tends to infinity. Then what is this probability?
Zero.
Zero.
Right. Probability is zero here. Is not one. Okay, I'll ask one more thing. What is the probability that x belongs to 0.2 to 0.7? Can you just tell me this value from this? Why 0.5? How you got 0.5?
0.7 minus 0.2 into height.
Height, right? Area under this PDF from 0.2 to 0.7. 0.2 to 0.7. This area corresponds to this probability, right? Area under this curve corresponds to probability. If you consider the single point, for example, 0.8, what is the area under this single point? It's always zero, right? Because width is zero. Width of this one is zero. Height is finite value, one. One into zero is zero. Area under single point. But if you consider some finite length for this one, 0.2 to 0.7 in this case, this length is 0.5. Height is 1, 0.5 into 1. This is having some finite area, non-zero area, right? This is a probability, 0.5. Same thing will work out for our Gaussian case also. What is the probability at x equal to mu for this Gaussian? It's a probability density function.
Zero.
That's zero, right? This is zero. Probability for any x value in this one is zero. If you consider some duration, some length, then you can try to find area under this curve. Suppose I want to find probability that x belongs to mu minus sigma to mu plus sigma, then that corresponds to area under this curve from mu minus sigma to mu plus sigma. This area corresponds to this probability. And total area should be 1, right? If you go from minus infinity plus infinity, area under this entire curve should be always 1 because it's a PDF, probability density function. And one more thing. For example, if I say x1 is Gaussian with mean value mu 1 and variance sigma 1 square, x2 is also a Gaussian random variable with mean value mu 2 and variance sigma 2 square, then how to find a giant PDF? The giant probability density function. How to find this? Can you just tell me what is f(x1) of x1?
One by root two pi sigma 1 square e power minus
x1
minus mu 1 square
by
2 sigma 1
square, right? Let me try to make it like I equal to 1 and 2. That's fine. For I equal to 1, you replace with 1. For I equal to 2, you replace with 2. That's fine. And yeah, if you know this marginal distribution, is there any way that you can find the giant distribution or giant PDF? Is it possible? Okay, I'll write one statement. You need to say whether that is right or wrong. Is it true? Is it true or false? This thing. Okay, let's go to your mode only. Your mode of learning will be different, right? Can I write like this? Just go to probability. Forget about this PDF. P of A intersection B equal to P of A and P of B. Can I write like this? A, B are events.
If they are independent, they can.
If they are independent, then you can write like this, right? If they are dependent, then how to write? How to split? If they are dependent.
Probability of A,
probability of B given A.
B given A, right? If they are independent, then B given A is same as B. Is there any other way for this?
Probability of B, probability of A given B.
A given B, right? Is the other way for this. When they are independent, probability of A given B is same as probability of A. Because this will not affect this one, right? When they are independent. Even though if you know something about this B, that won't affect this when they are independent. Same thing for this also. Yeah, do you think this is correct? Let's try to extend this one to PDFs, probability density function. Is it true, this statement? When this is true? Yes, when this can be true. You can answer, right? If they are independent, right? X1 and X2 are independent random variables. Then we can have this giant PDF. Is same as product of marginals, marginal PDFs. Like this you can have, when they are independent. Okay, have you heard about uncorrelated random variables, correlated? When can you say two random variables are independent? Can you give me any condition? Can you call this like condition for independency? Is it okay?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
This is condition for independence, right? Otherwise, you can go for CDF. That's also fine. If x1, x2 of x1, comma x2 equals to CDF product, right? This also fine. This also condition for independency. This is the condition for independency. What is the condition for uncorrelated random variables? Okay, I'll write one thing. X1 minus. Is the condition for uncorrelated random variables? Okay, I think you are getting confused with notations, right? Let's go for your traditional notations. I'll change this anyway. E of x y equal to E of x and E of y. I'll change this thing anyway. What is the meaning of this? Implies?
Uncorrelated random variables.
X, Y are uncorrelated random variables, right?
Yes, sir.
Do you think this statement is same as this statement are different? This and this. See, in place of X, I have X1. In place of Y, I have X2. In place of E of X, I have mu1. In place of E of Y, I have mu2. If you have doubt, you can expand this. X1 minus mu1 into X2 minus mu2 equals to E of X1 X2 minus X1 mu2 minus mu1 X2 plus mu1 mu2. Can you just tell me the expansion of this? Apply linearity for expectation. Then what is this second one? Note that mu1 equal to E of X1 and mu2 equal to E of X2. These are the means or expectations. Then what is this term? So you can speak out, right? What is E of 2x? Expectation of 2x? How to write this? Expectation of 2x. Can you write 2, like this?
2 into 2
R. Right? 2 is a constant. Then how to write this? Mean value is a constant value, right? It's a constant.
Mu 2 into E of X1.
Mu 2 into E of X1. It means mu 1 into mu 2, right? Mu 1, mu 2. Then what about this? Once again, mu 1, mu 2, right? And what about this? Expectation of constant. That is constant only, right? Plus mu 1, mu 2. This gets cancelled out. Which is same as, I'll try to rewrite this. E of X1, X2 minus E of X1 into E of X2. I'm saying that is uncorrelated when this is equal to 0. Implies E of X1 X2 equal to E of X1 into E of X2, right? Then you can say they are uncorrelated. This is actual meaning of correlation. It's a definition of correlation, right? The measure of correlation between random variables. From there you got this final formula. You should try to remember this. It's a basis, right? It's a basic point for you. If you say they are uncorrelated, this correlation should be equal to zero. This correlation should be equal to zero when they are uncorrelated. From there, you got this expression, E of xy equal to E of x into E of y. Correlation means relation between random variable x1 and random variable x2. That's what you are telling. It's an English meaning of correlation, right? There's a relation between these two random variables. Okay, if two random variables x and y are independent, can you say they are uncorrelated?
Yes, sir.
It's true, right? Can you do the reverse way?
Not possible all time, sir.
When this is possible? One example is when they are Gaussian.
When y and x are having linear relationship.
Not linear relationship. This is a condition for that. If x and y are Gaussian random variables and they are uncorrelated, in that example, uncorrelated random variable implies independent. Along with uncorrelated random variables, if they are Gaussian random variables, they are Gaussian, they will follow Gaussian PDF, then they will be independent. Oh, can someone tell me, have you seen this one? Jointly Gaussian random variable. Have you heard this yet? We have heard this. Jointly Gaussian random variables. Let me say x1, x2 are jointly Gaussian random variables. You can answer me. No need to tell me that formula. I want to know whether you came across jointly Gaussian distribution in your probability course or not. Is it covered in your course?
No, sir.
Okay, that's not covered. Okay, let me try to give you the intuition. X bar is a random vector, x1, x2. For example, just two-dimensional vector. If you want, you can go for n dimension also, x1, x2 up to xn. Just for basic understanding, I am going for two dimension, that's it. Each of them are random variables and this is jointly Gaussian. Then the concerned giant PDF can be written like this. It's similar to that only. Let's try to compare with your one dimension case. X Gaussian. Let's try to compare with that one so that you can remember this easily. Mean, right? Mu whole square by 2 sigma square. In a similar manner, you are going to have this whole square. Here you have 1 by root 2 pi whole power 1. Single random variable, right? We have two random variables. That's why we are going to have whole square for this. Into under root sigma square, right? Here you are going to have under root mod r, where r is the correlation matrix. No, this is not correlation. Covariance matrix. Covariance matrix. R is the covariance matrix. Into e power minus. Okay, space is not enough for me. E power minus something. This one I'll try to write here. X bar minus mu bar whole transpose R inverse into X bar minus mu bar. By 2. Something similar to this. Divide by 2 you are having, right? That 2 will come here once again. The X bar minus mu bar. X bar means x1, x2 in this case. Mu bar means the constant mean values. Mu1, mu2. It's a jointly Gaussian random variable. If this is n dimensional vector, x1, x2 up to xn, this 2 will be replaced with n. That's it. Same expression you are going to get. Where R corresponds to E of x bar minus mu bar into x bar minus mu bar transpose. For example, let's go with this basic case where you have just two variables in this. Can you just tell me the dimension of this? Is it a scalar or a matrix? It's a 2 cross 1. What is the dimension of this?
One cross.
Okay, scalar. Before that, see, what is the dimension of x bar minus mu bar?
That is also 2 cross 1.
2 cross 1, right? What is the dimension of this transpose?
1 cross 2.
Then what is the dimension of that product?
2 cross 2.
2 cross 2, right? It's a matrix, it's not a scalar. R is the matrix. In this example, that is 2 cross 2. If that is n dimension, n cross n. Yeah, for example, yeah, I'll have this. E of x minus x bar minus mu 1, right? X1 minus mu 1, x2 minus mu 2 into x1 minus mu 1, x2 minus mu 2. See, this is 2 cross 1. See, 1 cross 2. Overall, that is 2 cross 2. Yeah, can you just tell me the expansion of this? What is first term? It's a 2 cross 2, right? What is first term?
X1 minus mu1.
X1 minus mu1. What is second term? This into this, right? X1 minus mu1 into x2 minus mu2. And what is third term? This into this, right?
X2, x2 minus mu2
into x1 minus mu1. What is fourth term?
X2 minus mu2 whole square.
X2 minus mu2 whole square, right? You can take this expectation inside this. Expectation of this. Expectation of this. Expectation of this. And expectation of this. Can you just tell me this? What is this first one? If x1 is a random variable with mean value mu1 and variance sigma1 square, then what is this? What is E of x1 minus mu1 whole square?
Variance of x1.
It's variance, right? This is sigma 1 square. Then what about this?
Sigma 2 square.
This is also variance, right? Sigma 2 square. Then what about this?
Correlation.
It's a covariance, right? This is covariance. This can be written like this. Sigma 1 2 square. And what about this?
Sigma 2 1 square.
See, in general, people will try to write like this also. 1 1 2 2. Why means, can you guess that? Why I can write like 1 1? Because see, x1 minus mu1 and x1 minus mu1, right? 1 I am writing because E of x1 minus mu1 into x2 minus mu2. In place of this, I have once again 1, 1. That's why I can go for this notation. Just for my convenience. This can be written like 2, 1 square, right? It's a covariance between 1, 2. 2, 1. Do you think the two are equal or different? Is it same or they are different?
same, sir.
They are same, right? If they are same, can you call it like a symmetric matrix? R transpose equal to R. Is it true? See, R is a covariance matrix.
Yes, sir.
It's a symmetric, right? It's a symmetric matrix. It means covariance matrix is a symmetric matrix. That's fine. Suppose if you are having n dimensional vector x1, x2, and so on, xn. Let's go with the d dimension. D means dimension, right? You want to go with this notation for pattern recognition. Okay, that's fine. D dimensional vector, d cross 1. Then can you just tell me what is covariance matrix for this? At least tell me the diagonal terms.
Sigma 1 1 square.
Okay. Or you can say sigma 1 square also.
Sigma 2 square. So on up to sigma n square.
D square, right? D the dimension. This is D cross D matrix. Then what is this?
Sigma 1 2.
1 3 square and so on. Sigma 1 D square. Like this, right? Sigma 2 1 square. Sigma 3 1 square and so on. Sigma D 1 square. These two are equal. Sigma 1 D square is same as D 1 square. 1 3 square is same as 3 1 square. They are symmetric by default. It means if you know these values, you can find this straight away, right? By copy paste. You can copy paste this to this. That's it. No need to redo once again, right? Once you got these values, they are just duplicates of them. That's it. Because of this property, R transpose equal to R symmetric. Okay, that's fine. Let me go with some special cases. Suppose yes, if that is jointly Gaussian, x1, x2 are jointly Gaussian random variables. Jointly Gaussian random variables with covariance equal to zero. Covariance means sigma 1 2 equal to 0 implies sigma 2 1, right? What is the meaning of this? When covariance equal to 0, what is the meaning of this? They are uncorrelated, right? Is it true?
Yes, sir.
Because that is same as E of x1 minus mu 1 into x2 minus mu 2. Suppose if they are uncorrelated, if they are uncorrelated and jointly Gaussian random variables, in that case, what will be your R covariance matrix? Sigma 2 square, 0 and 0, right? Is it okay? Sigma 1 2 square, 2 1 square, right? They are zeros. 2 cross 2. Okay, from this, can you try to guess what is your fx1, x2? Let's try to have this. Root 2 pi. I can write inside also, no problem for me, right? R inverse. Yeah, can you try to tell me what is this? What is mod R? We can show the case like this, right? And what is mod R? What is the determinant? Mod means determinant. What is the determinant of this one? Determinant.
Sigma 1 square minus sigma 1 square into sigma.
Minus 0, right? This is sigma 1 square, sigma 2 square. You can replace this one with sigma 1 square, sigma 2 square. Then what is your R inverse? It's just a 2D, 2 cross 2 matrix, right? What is your R inverse for this? This one, right? Is it R inverse? See, this is diagonal matrix.
Yes, sir.
No need to go through determinant like that. Straight away, you can take the inverse of the diagonal elements, right?
Yes, sir.
This will be 1 by sigma 1 square, this will be 1 by sigma 2 square. This is just a diagonal matrix. If you want to multiply both, you are going to get identity matrix I. If you multiply this and this. 1 by sigma 1 square, 1 by sigma 2 square. This is R inverse. Okay, can you just simplify this and tell me the answer? This part. X minus mu whole transpose means x1 minus mu1 mu2 into R inverse 1 by sigma 1 square 1 by sigma 2 square 0 0 into I'm just trying to write this. Can someone tell me what is this answer? It's a diagonal. You can go straight away. No need to do on paper also. It's simply x1 minus mu1 whole square by sigma 1 square plus h2 minus mu2 whole square by sigma 2 square. If you want, you can multiply. You can multiply this. After that, multiply with this. You are going to end up with this expression. X minus mu. X1 minus mu1 whole square by sigma 1 square plus h2 minus mu2 whole square by sigma 2 square. And we have mod r equal to sigma 1 square into sigma 2 square. Then can you say this? Is it true or false? I will try to write one statement. Where x1 is Gaussian with mean value mu1 where in sigma 1 square and x2 is Gaussian with mean value mu2 and where in sigma 2 square. Is it true or false in this particular case?
True, sir.
It's true, right? You try to substitute this into this expression. E power minus a plus b is same as e power minus a into e power minus b, right? Similarly, you can try to split this into two parts. You are going to end up with this expression. What is the meaning of this?
They are independent.
Independent, right? We started with uncorrelated random variables and giantly Gaussian. We ended up with independent Gaussian, right? It means for Gaussian case, for giantly Gaussian random variables, if they are uncorrelated, you can call them like independent also. That will work out. And one more thing. Yes. X1, X2 are giantly Gaussian. And uncorrelated. their mean values and variances are equal, mu. Sigma I square equal to sigma square. For I equal to 1 comma 2. Then can you just tell me f x1 x2 of x1 comma x2? That final simplified expression I want. Generally Gaussian random variables and uncorrelated with same mean, same variance. Then what is this? See, by default uncorrelated means?
They are independent.
Independent, right? You can simply multiply their marginal PDFs, right? You can multiply their marginal PDFs. Or if you try to simplify this one, even if you go as a procedure, you are going to end up with this one. Root 2 pi sigma square, whole square, right? E power minus, then what will be this one? Is it okay? See, I just done this. E power minus A and E power minus B equal to E power minus of A plus B. That's what I had done here. Or you try to substitute in the matrix format also, you are going to end up with this only, finally. It's just product of marginals, right? That's what you are going to expect. Can you generalize this one to D dimension? Suppose x1, x2 and so on, xd, d cross 1 and jointly Gaussian. And suppose this is given to you, E of xi equals to mu and variance sigma I square equals to sigma square for all I equal to 1 to D. Then can you just tell me the giant distribution if x bar of x bar is x1 to HD, x1 to HD. Yeah, what is this? You can generalize by using this.
1 by
giant Gaussian uncorrelated. One by root 2 pi.
Root 2 pi sigma square whole power d e power minus x minus summation I is equal to some 1 to
d
x I minus mu
whole square by
pi 2
sigma square, right? This is a giant distribution you are going to get when they are uncorrelated. It implies independent, right? In that case. Suppose E of x I equal to mu I, sigma I square equal to sigma I square only. Then what will happen? Just replace this, that's what, right? And in this case, what you are going to get? If you have whole power D up to this, then what about this? I equal to 1 to D, sigma I square. That's what you are going to get, right?
Yes, sir.
When they are equal, sigma square whole power D, root A power D is same as root A whole power D. Is it true or false?
True, sir.
That's true, right? You see, a power 1 is whole power 1 by 2. We can write this like whole power 1 by 2. A power m whole power n is same as a power mn. Same as a power n whole power m, right? Root means power 1 by 2. Like that you can take. Okay. almost 1 hour, right? Oof. I want to suggest one more thing regarding your career. You note down this one. This will be helpful for you in future. And one more thing. In Coursera, I can go. You can try to do this course. Total there will be 5 courses. Deeplearning.ai. This is by Professor Andrew Ng. Total there will be 5 courses. Each course will be roughly for 10 hours only. Roughly you can expect 40 to 50 hours duration for this entire specialization. If you do this course, it will be helpful for your placements when you go to E4. Deeplearning.ai. This only. You can note down this one. Some of your seniors already got benefited with this one. If you have done this, it will be helpful for your placements. Okay, do you have any doubts? You can ask me. See, no problem. You can ask the doubts, right? See, if you don't have doubt, I can think only one thing. Either you know everything or you know nothing. There are only 2 cases. Okay, that's fine. Thank you.